is going to talk about the idea of balance in our lives with the margin, finding the balance in a demanding world, and just the idea of finding that balance of work and life, and just how we learn that through our experiences, and how we can, from mistakes and from experiences, how we find that we need to take care of ourselves and finding those things. And so Cassie's going to give that presentation. She is a mother of two, soon to be three. And she is a doctor at the
West Wichita Family Physicians.
There it is, West Wichita Family Physicians. I couldn't think of the name of it. But her and I graduated together, and so I thought being able to talk about something that she's passionate about and that she's learned from and that she's kind of applied in her life, I thought this would be very effective and very practical for us. So I'm going to turn it over to Cassie, and here we go.
Thanks, Daniel. So like you said, Cassandra Gerlach, I got diagnosed, I graduated in 2008. I graduated from KU Med Center in 2012, did my residency through family medicine at Via Christi. Graduated in 2015, and then shortly after that, I started private practice at West Wichita. So I've been there for about 3 years and just became partner about 2 weeks ago. So this talk, Daniel texted me and asked me to find something to talk about. I threw out a really bad idea. We backtracked and found this one. So this is a topic that during your intern year of residency, so that's your very first year of residency, of being a doctor, you're a newbie, they try to make sure you're still alive and doing well, essentially. So they make you go through these monthly meetings. And this was one of the topics that really changed the course of where my career was going. I was initially going to do full scope family practice with inpatient, outpatient, delivering babies, running an ER, working in rural Kansas medicine. And then after this, I think maybe the next month I got pregnant with my first kid, and that kind of changed, babies change where your life goes, and this topic was a good one. So this is essentially what margin is. I don't have very many slides, I'm basically talking about my mistakes, but margin is that space between you and your limits. So what that means is finding that, that balance, that knowing where you need to draw the line, and giving you that buffer in case there's something unexpected that happens, so you're able to accommodate, so you're not overloaded, you're not, we call it burnout in medicine, where you're just 24 hours a day, go, 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 and then all of a sudden you hit a wall. And it's hard to know when you're gonna hit that wall until you actually hit it. So during undergrad, I wrote this down, but I think I can remember this. I did 20 credit hours at one time. I was working almost full-time for my dad, running the parts department of this tractor company. I was waitressing at Texas Roadhouse in the evenings. I was a campus minister, running retreats and different events on campus. And then I was also prepping and teaching the microbiology lab while the professor was on maternity leave. So needless to say, I had a lot on my plate. And then at the same time, I was also a scholar in rural health, which is an early admission program for KU. So you get admitted a year before everybody else, but you have to do a bunch of shadowing hours, projects. It's a lot of work. So all of that kind of took a toll on me, but I still kept going because that's what you have to do if you want to get into med school and be a doctor. You just never stop, you keep going. So then in med school, it's kind of the same thing. You sit through a lecture, you study until about 2 o'clock in the morning, you go to bed, you do it all over again, and then you're in clinic for the third and fourth year, and then residency hits, and you're doing 16 to 30 hours a day. Yes, there's not 30 hours in a day, but the shifts are very long, and they don't really put, they finally put a cap on how much you're allowed to work, so you're not allowed to exceed 80 hours a week. So that was kind of them. But I was pregnant for the majority of residency with two newborns, and now pregnant with the third. So essentially what this taught me is just to be able to take a step back and realize how much I was sacrificing of myself to be able to do what I needed to do. Because being a doctor, you go into it because it's you're a servant, right? You have that servant-like attitude to serve people, to take care of them, to heal, and to be there when nobody else can be there. And with that, you kind of get this inability to say no. So when Daniel texts about 3 weeks before this and asks you to do a talk on a Saturday morning, sure, why not? And I hate public speaking, so this is this is even worse for me. So and there's a book, it was written by Dr. Richard Swenson. He's a family medicine doctor, and it's called Margin. But it's essentially talking about this new concept of finding that balance. Because we all know what stress is, but then how do we, once we recognize when we're stressed, how do we take a step back and fix that? So this, I kind of made up, but this is the three things that I went through trying to figure out what did I want in my life. So, you know, during undergrad, they want you to know your 5-year plan. But really, what do you want your end goal in life to be? And for most of us, all of us, it should be to get to heaven. You know, that's your number one goal. So when you look at your life, are you doing things to get you to that place? And then everything else that you have as a goal in life while you're here, you need to be able to say, this is what I want. And then the next step is, what are your priorities? So when we went through marriage prep 7-8 years ago with Father Sawyer, God is number one, right? Your spouse is number two, your kids are number three, and then there's everything else underneath. And it's up to you to figure out the order of everything. And it's going to fluctuate. But if you know what your priorities are, then you have a better idea of how you're going to get there. And then also how you want to, what do you want to do to get there. So giving a talk on a Saturday morning, or going on a mission trip, or taking off work to be with your kids, to take, you know, to find that balance. You just need to figure that out, so that you're able to actually make it to your goal and actually be happy at the end and say, I did the things that I needed to do to make it there. So there's a bunch of different things in the book. This is a long list, but he talks about a bunch of different things, emotional overload, financial overload, physical overload, so not getting enough sleep, not eating the right things, not taking the time to take care of your health, and then this is the list that he came up with. So out of this, if you get anything out of my talk today, this is a very short talk, but I want you to take a look at this list and try to find something that that you can work on. So without even realizing it, because I just read this book recently, for the last 2 Lents, I've done something to help make, hopefully make myself towards the goal that I'm trying to get to, right? Heaven, being a better mom, a better doctor, better mother. So 2 Lents ago, I gave up the radio. I sit in complete silence in the car, which is actually very nice. And then working on, you know, spirituality, getting myself closer to God. I pray the rosary in the car every day on the way to work. And then on the way home, I sit in complete silence and kind of contemplate what's happened. Because if you don't take that time for yourself, really think about your day and what happened and process it, and things start to pile up, right? And then all of a sudden they explode, or you get bottled up and get anxious or depressed, and it just spirals from there. And then this most recent Lent, I gave up Facebook, which I thought was going to be hard, but I love it. I'm getting ready to delete my account, but it's given me more time. Not that it was really consuming much of my life, but I don't find myself even looking at my phone anymore, right? Staying away from it. The only time I really look at it around my kids is if I get a page from my patients. So, and now I'm working on some of the other things. But if there's something that, you know, you can pinpoint in your life that's really making you stressed, if you take a step back, there's usually other things that you can change to help you be able to manage that situation a little bit better. So some of these are fixed. So you're not just going to quit work and quit life and go live on an island and drink mimosas all day, right? But there are some of these that you can make adjustments to. So Daniel and I, just before this talk, we were talking about, I used to be a type A person. I was still am very driven, but I've become more of an introvert, and I get exhausted being around people all day, right? And so that's one of these overload, which when I initially read the book, I thought, people overload, how are you going to change that? But it's really just, you know, recognizing that sometimes us introverts. I know extroverts thrive on being around people and talking and interacting all day, but sometimes we just need to take a step back and be by ourselves for a little bit and regroup and recharge. Some of the other things, I don't know if young mothers or young parents, so the commitment and the activity overload that can take over your life when you've got young children, with the sports and the school and the activities that they get involved in. I think it's also important to teach your kids this, you know, not get them involved in 100 different things, but maybe pick a couple so they still have that time on the weekends to relax and be a kid and run around and do what they need to do. And then another thing that he touched on in the book is the debt and the possession. Debt can be very hard to get out of. I'm still working on it from med school and being a partner and all that. But the possession part too, so I don't have a credit card, so I don't buy anything that I can't afford. Everything's used, I buy consignment clothes for my, you know, everything. We do as much as we can to save as much money as we can. But the possession kind of goes along with the debt, so we kind of get tied into what we buy and keeping up with the Joneses. We feel this, you know, they have this and I need that, and kind of spirals out of control. So if you can get a handle on that, that can help as well. So I know this is short, but I just wanted to give you guys some tips on maybe working on one thing and then taking it from there, just to get yourself to that end goal. Making sure that you're taking time for, you know, confession at least once a month, and if you're Catholic, I'm not making any assumptions, or going to Mass, prayer, taking time with your spouse, date night every month or so. I take dates with my kids now too, because they get really upset when I don't. And then taking that time for yourself, because I think that'll make you better everything if you take that time to decompress and spend that time. So this is my family. Reagan Gianna, she's 4, and then Sebastian is 2. And then I'm doing August with our next.